Time now for the Help Desk, where we get answers to your financial questions. Joining me this hour, Manisha Thakur is a personal finance author, and Doug Flynn is a certified financial planner and founder of Flynn Zito. Let's get right to the first question. Carrie in Santa Monica, California asks, my husband lost his job 2 years ago. We've sold our house, we've drained our savings, so we took $250,000 from our retirement account. Now, our real earnings were about $40,000 in odd jobs. Is withdrawing from your retirement account considered earnings for that year, Doug?
This is horrible. First of all, it is, and it's going to catapult them into the highest tax bracket. Now, I don't even know if they're over 59.5, but if they're not, they've got 35% federal, probably 10% on the California, which is where they are, and then another 10% penalty for being not 59.5. They're losing probably half of that money. Mm-hmm. I have no idea why they would take that money out in a lump sum unless you needed that money in a lump sum. Mm-hmm. What most people don't know is if you take that out, you do have 60 days to put it back in without the taxes or penalties. So my first advice is, unless you're spending that today, roll that right back in and avoid that, and look at possibly living off of that on a monthly basis. It'll lower your tax bill. That's the way to do that.
Definitely. Big tax bill. Thanks, Doug. And the next question is from Todd in Hope, Alaska. Todd asks, I've accumulated a growing sum in family health savings account. Now, how can I transfer it to a higher yielding vehicle without losing that tax favored status that we all know and love? Manisha.
Okay, Carmen, that's a fun question. It's rare these days that somebody says, I have extra money.
Right.
So the short answer is talk to your plan administrator. There are options within your plan, oftentimes, that can scale up the risk-reward spectrum. But the slightly longer answer is I want to caution Todd that it may feel like you've got a nice chunk of change there, but healthcare costs can come out of the blue. They're big. And I recommend if you've got to spend the money in the next 1 to 5 years, don't put it in stocks or bonds. You want to protect it against inflation. Rates aren't great right now, but I'd rather you have that money if something happens next year or the year after than take additional risk in that particular account.
All right, great. Thank you guys so much for joining us. Now, do you have a question that you want us to answer? I want you to send us an email anytime at CNN Help Desk @CNN.com.